In this video, we'll be showing you how you can use your infotainment system, like how you can play music files, video files, or even what you can do with image files, and also other settings that you might find for the infotainment system. Hi guys, my name is Don, and I'm not a pro driver. So I just want to focus first on these icons right here. You would see icons here on the lower right corner of the panel. For the first one, we have the wireless charger. Now, nothing's lighting up at this point because I don't have anything charging. But if I do add a phone here, you would see that it will light up. So now it's charging. There we go. And you would hear a beep, right? So that's what it does. In a way, I'm seeing this as your status bar. You know, when you have on our phones, we have like the navigation bar. Before that, at the very top, you have like your status bar where it tells you the battery levels, your signal for 5G or Wi-Fi and whatnot, your time. So this is it. This is kind of what it is to me, at least. So after the wireless charger indicator, we have USB 1 and USB 2. So USB 1 is actually here. This is USB 1, this one, and then this is USB 2. So if ever I place anything in here, so for example, I have this flash drive right now. If I place this in USB 1, how do I put this? All right, there we go. You would see that this thing lights up. You would see USB 1, and if I put the flash drive in USB 2, then USB 2 lights up. The next thing is the volume indicator. So here you would see that it is throwing out some sound, right? So I have volume here. It's just not playing anything at this point. But if I mute, you would see that the speaker has like an X. And if I unmute this, then you would see, oops. If I, you would see that it has this like waveform type of thing, whatever. It's just throwing out sound, right? And then below that, we have Bluetooth indicator. And that is for when your phone is connected to Bluetooth, it will show up. And the cool thing about that is after you connect your device to Bluetooth, here in the infotainment system, you would have a battery indicator as well. It will tell you your battery of the actual device, not the infotainment system because it doesn't need battery. It's your actual device, all right? Now, before we get into Bluetooth or anything else, I just want to show that when you go into the cloud here and tap on settings, we have Bluetooth here. And usually we have vehicle name. This is your Bluetooth name. I can actually rename this if I choose to. So I'll just say something like, I don't know, Tiggo. Confirm. And now, if I turn on my Bluetooth on my phone, I should be able to see that. Oh, okay. First of all, you must make it discoverable. All right. There is this one thing that 180 seconds, it will be discoverable for 180 seconds. And then at this point, you should see Tiggo appear, supposedly. There we go. All right, so I tap on Tiggo, and then I'll pair this, pair, and then allow contacts and favorites sync. The favorites is like your contacts as well, all right? And that's at least for the iPhone. And then here on your infotainment screen, you would see there are paired devices, so that's my phone. And then if there are other devices as well that has Bluetooth on, you will see available devices here as well. All right, so that's pretty much it on how you would connect your phone. Oh, the other thing is in our status bar, right? You can see there is a Bluetooth icon. It lit up, and then there's a phone next to it, and then the battery level, which is true enough, I'm sort of like low on battery. So you can see there. Now I'll just charge this for now and leave this here. All right. So we're still in settings and we have sound. If I tap on sound, key tone, what does this do? Well, it just, every time you tap on the screen, there will be like some tone. So these are settings just for sound, you know, for your sound system and whatnot. The next thing is we have display. So there will be light mode and then there will be night, day. The only difference is it changes the brightness of the screen. So right now it's in day, so it's brighter. Right? It would be brighter. And then night, we would have this. And then I just put it on auto. And then we have wallpaper. And these are the wallpapers by default. And then we have restore defaults. I don't want to do that. Screen switch. Whatever I do here, it just turns off. And then I tap again, it turns on. So screen switch does nothing for me, at least. And then we have settings right here. That's wireless charge. If I turn this off, then I don't have wireless charging, even if I charge it, I guess. And then phone forgotten. This feature actually is cool because If I am charging, all right, so I'll hear a beep when I charge this wirelessly. Hold on. There we go, right? So if I turn this off right now, the vehicle, I open my door. So that's the sound that you would hear, and it will repeat. I just can't open the door because it's raining. But you would hear that, and don't be alarmed. It's just the car telling you that you forgot your phone and it's charging on the wireless charger. Now here, we have tuner area, which is Asia. We're in the Philippines at this point, okay? And then version info, nothing useful for us. Storage. Now, this is interesting because this is where it tells me that it does have storage, right? You can store files on the infotainment system, which is cool. All right. So let's go to music. Now, you would see that you have local, USB 1, USB 2, and Bluetooth. If I'm playing something on my phone right now, because my phone is connected via Bluetooth, remember? We have that here on the status bar. If I'm playing something, like, I don't know, let me play something in music. So I'm playing something now. So if I go to Bluetooth, that's the actual sound coming from my phone, right? So if I pause this, then it will pause. If I play, there we go. So that's when you just tap on Bluetooth. It needs to have a device connected. Now we're moving on to local. Right now it says no music file because I haven't transferred anything yet into the infotainment system. We have USB 1, which is, again, is disabled because I haven't plugged anything on the USB 1 port. In USB 2, it actually scans for the whole flash drive for music files. So you will just see a list of music files right here. And then you would notice that whenever there's like a file, you know, being shown here, this button, a list with a drop-down toggle type of thing, actually appears, right? So you could see, you could sort it by album. So those are the albums, right, of the USB. You have artists. So you could sort them out depending on the file, the metadata coming from the file. So it's actually smart in some way. But the cool thing here is, since that I don't have anything on local, I can transfer all of these files in local. We can just like cherry pick which songs we want. So whenever a song is playing like that, so this is like the detail view of the music. If I tap on heart, you would see that marked as local music. So now this Chicane 1000 More Sons.mp3 will actually be playable as well here on local. So if I remove USB 2, you would see that USB 2 is disconnected, and then we have local. And this song, I can play this song locally. Cool, right? Now the question is, how do I transfer all the songs from one USB drive to the infotainment system? All right, so I just plugged the same USB drive in USB 1. So right now it's lit up, USB 1. So I can tap on this, like a list. It's not really a list, is it? It looks like a file, a document file with an icon. So if I tap on that, you would see there are checkboxes. Now, if there are checkboxes on the left, that means they are selectable right here. But I can just select all right here. There we go. Now it selects all of them. And then if I tap on this, there we go. Marking as favorite. So mark as local music. So whatever I have here originally in USB 1 is the same now in local. So that's music. Remember, we have 5 gigabytes of storage in our infotainment system. You can just use that all for songs, right? If there are a lot of music files, let's go to USB 1. So you have a bunch of, let's say, music files, and the way you would arrange them is put them in one folder and make that folder a playlist. You could actually do that. Go into this, all music, and then folder. And then from here, this is your root directory of the USB flash drive. Right now, I just have one. It will scan all folders that will have music files. So at this time, it's just music folder. And if I tap on music folder, then I have Chicane and Tiesto, right? So if I just tap on Tiesto here, it will just give me all the songs in that folder. So that's cool, right? So that means that if I tap on the music file here, I could just, you know, move to the previous track and it will loop within that same folder. In picture, that's the same thing as well, going to root directory. And then we have grids and wallpapers, right? And then I can just select wallpaper, and these are all the wallpapers. And if I tap on one, you would see that this is the detailed view of the wallpaper. And if I want to use this actually as a wallpaper here on my infotainment system, I could tap on the farmost right icon here. It looks like an image icon. There we go. Wallpaper is being set up. And then wait until it says set wallpaper successfully, right? So now if I go back to my infotainment screen here, you would see that, true enough, the wallpaper has changed. Now you could do this up to 5 times. So if I tap on this. I'll just set this one. I'll do this 5 times because usually after the 5th time, it will tell you that it will override 1 because it can't hold anything else, if I'm understanding that correctly. Oh, by the way, so technically what this is doing when it says wallpaper is already set up, it actually copies the file from the USB drive into the infotainment system. So you don't need to worry that if you remove your USB drive from the port, that this will not work anymore, that the wallpaper won't appear anymore. It will still appear and you will still have those selections. All right, so I'll do this 1 more time. So that's 5. Oh, there we go. So this is what it tells me after you have like 5 wallpapers already in storage. You would know that you would have 5 storage if I go back. Let me tap cancel and then go back, and then here in picture, sorry, in settings, and then going back to display and then wallpaper, you would see that there, yeah, true enough, I have 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Now if I go back, let's go back here, picture, and then tap on this and say that I want this as my wallpaper, replace the existing wallpaper. What is it going to be replacing? It will replace the oldest one. That's what you can do with images. Plus, you can actually play just, you know, if you have a photo of, I don't know, family in retreats or, you know, outings or whatnot, you can just hit play here. And if I hit play, it's like a slideshow. That's what it is. I don't know the interval, the time per image, but yeah, that's what it does. And for video, there's not much here for video. It's just a list of videos. Again, you could go into folder, and then if there are video files on those folders, then it will appear here. And then you can select a folder, and then these are the video files, right? Now, if I hit play here, yeah, there we go. So it is playing. You might notice that there are no other options like copying or heart for the video. It seems like you can't copy video files here on the infotainment system. So if you want to view something, a video, you have to have your USB flash drive or probably like a 500 gigabyte hard drive. Those types of removable hard drives, you could just stick it in there and then play all your videos, seasons, whatnot. So this is one way of watching a video while driving. It disappears though whenever the AVM feature kicks in, all right? Because the only time that this will disappear is, so for example, if I would trigger the signal light or hit reverse, it will automatically go into parking assist. So if I hit reverse, there we go. But if I'm moving forward, at least for me, it doesn't stop playing. It still keeps going up until, I think I tested it, I don't know, 50 kilometers per hour. It still is playing. But yeah, so that's video. What else do we have in the infotainment system? Yeah, if you have your phone connected, then you have your contact list here. You can contact them, you can dial them, you can receive calls. You can use the controls found here on the steering wheel to drop and receive a call and whatnot. If you're interested to know more about how you can connect your phone, like an Android phone or an iPhone, check out the video here. Thank you so much. Hanggang sa uli din, kita kits.